Hello, welcome to episode 444 of Oatmeal Breakfast Plays a Video Game. On this episode I play a video game for the Sega Master System called Super Space Invaders Rev 1 on Internet Archive. The game is from 1991. Even though I did not make it off the first level, I enjoyed playing the game. I have never said that about a video game before. The graphics look good, and the sounds are okay. I don't remember if there are sounds in this game or not. There probably are. Anyway, I like it. Before I decided to play Space Invaders Revolution on the show, I thought of maybe I will play Rocky, but that would take too long, and I thought about Walter Payton football, but I don't really know how to play that game. So I settled on Space Invaders Rev 1. I don't have anything more to say about the game, so I will talk about Inkscape. I watched some more TJ3 Inkscape videos. I learned that about Pixabay. It's a website where I can get pictures to use in Inkscape, and a lot of the pictures are free for commercial use. I was so excited. I also learned that I can drag a picture into Inkscape to trace it with the Bezier tool. I never knew I could trace a picture with Inkscape. How cool is that? It's like Blender, except with Blender I have to load a picture into Blender. I also learned about the freehand drawing tool, and to try and avoid using it. So after I learned about using the Bezier tool and getting a picture into Inkscape, I went to Pixabay and looked at pictures. I decided to download a picture of a heart. I put the picture in Inkscape and traced it with the Bezier tool. It was fun. I had to add more Bezier node. The heart was looking a little jagged, so I figured out how to smooth the path. It made it look better. I looked up Valentine's Day colors and added them to the heart and stroke around the heart. I also added text. One problem I have is I wonder how to get fonts I download from Font Squirrel into Inkscape. It would be easy on Windows, but I am using Puppy Linux. I will figure it out. If I can't figure out how to get the fonts into Inkscape, I figure I could load the ping of the image I made in Inkscape and add the text to my drawings in GIMP. So it's not the end of the world if I can't figure out how to add fonts to Inkscape. Since I also want to learn how to use GIMP. I never thought I would find fonts that I could find free for commercial use, and pictures free for commercial use. So I have done two things I never thought I could do. Now all I have to do is make drawings so I remember how to use Inkscape and GIMP. I wonder why I have never used Inkscape that much. It's fun to use. At least I am using it now. I can't wait to see what I make in Inkscape and GIMP. I think Blender is a lot harder to use than Inkscape or GIMP. I am still not that good at using Blender, but I find using it fun. I still have not upgraded to Blender 2.80, or is it 2.9 by now? With GIMP it's harder, because I also have to worry about lighting my scene. I don't have to worry about lights in Inkscape. And who knows, maybe I can even make 2D animations in Inkscape. What else do I want to talk about? I am having a hard time thinking of anything to talk about. I watched a video about how to grow figs in pots. One of my favorite cookies is Fig Newtons. I assume with a name like that they have figs in the filling. I don't ever remember eating plain old figs though. I used to eat regular Fig Newtons, and strawberry Fig Newtons, they are good. I want to eat a whole container of Fig Newtons right now, ha. I was thinking, what is it that pollinates fig trees? I know it's fascinating how fig trees get pollinated. But I can't remember exactly what pollinates them. I probably will remember later. I hope one day I have a show about RC cars. I don't exactly know what I would do on the show, or what RC vehicles I would cover, but I think it would be fun to have a show about RC cars. I am not that knowledgeable them yet. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.